Good afternoon, this video begins the next stage of testing media players. SDR and HDR we have already tested, now left the most desirable, but at the same time the most controversial video option is Dolby Vision. So hopefully this series of tests can dot the I's and cross the T's. The following players will participate in this series of tests. You can see them on the screen, small comments on the list. Oppo clone is a 100% copy of Oppo UDP-203 itself. Only without disk drive, but using the same latest firmware, with all the extra features of this firmware. We will take this unit as a reference for profile 7 and 8. Also we have Dune Real Vision 4K and Zidoo Z9x, which are claimed to have full 7 profile support. If you read the first reviews on these devices, it was underlined there that these players can play images and can play full FAL layer and even provide better image. But what is actually, we will find out in the process of tests. Also coming soon for the Testfire TV Cube 3rd generation. I have been asked by many to test it, because of its upscale, plus it has the fastest processor of Android players. It won't have time to take part in the first part, so it will catch up with everyone later, hopefully by the second part. Apple TV will not participate in this test. For a very simple reason, it does not know how to work properly even with Profile 8. But going back to the previous video about RGB tunneling, we tested it separately. And it turned out that Apple TV and Shield TV Pro 2019 are the two media players that know how to really work in TV LED mode. And of course Oppo clone, all the rest are fake TV LED players. In fact, all the others know how to work only in LLDV mode. When all the processing does the player and the TV already comes completely finished signal processed. I will use EDID from Sony TV with LLDV support but with color parameters taken from LG CX. I had to do it because of the Amazon players. The thing is that you cannot force the LLDV output. An EDID from LG CX can work in both DV modes. So I had to make some kind of prefabricated EDID. Another small difference is that Sony's edit has a maximum brightness of 807 nits and the LG CX's is 750 nits. So we will have a test on a Sony TV with only LLDV support but a white point from the LG CX. By the way, EDID for Dolby Vision plays a very important role, then I will show you its effect on the image. Another clarification, all players will use custom Kodi 21 Omega, it is the only version of Kodi, unofficial, which is able to correctly convert Dolby Vision on the fly from 7 profile to 8. This firstly solves a problem with Amazon devices that were playing a black screen instead of Dolby Vision, and secondly, you'll see the difference in how it affects the picture when playing the 7 profile. The only players where Kodi won't be used are the Dune Real Vision 4K player and the Zidoo Z9X, they have their own built-in players and Kodi doesn't work quite right on them. And also Homatics box are 4K we will compare in some cases in two modes of operation, in the native Dune app on Android and in Korilek. The thing is that I have the Homatics version from Dune. There, AFR only works in the native Dune app, and the app also allows you to play UHD images in the 7th profile. So it will be interesting to compare it with Korilek, which has built-in custom version of Kodi 21 with on-the-fly conversion of 7 profile to 8.1. Well, let's begin our tests. I will release them in small videos, so it is more convenient and faster for me to do them and it will be easier for you to perceive the material. The first test, it is a test of ability and correctness of work with L1 and L2 parameters from CM2.9. I will not tell the theory here, who is interested, find information on the internet. Here is the information from the Dolby Tools first test file, it is an 8 profile with an MDL of 1000 nit. As usual I won't tell you everything, I will only tell you the differences between players, if several players have the same result, I will show their results as one. I hope everything is clear. In this test, we will not evaluate the results and compare them, there will simply be a table showing which of the parameters are responding and which are not, so that we can understand how well the player can work with CM2.9. As you can see from the table, the best results showed Shield TV and Fire TV Max. This is probably due to the CM4.0 support, which only these two players have. There is a response to all parameters except MS weight. All other players don't react on L2 chroma weight, although it is not often used in movies, but still there are some. The worst result was shown, oddly enough, Oppo clone. It has no response to L1 optimal and L1 high contrast. But perhaps in this file these parameters are set somehow not quite right. Therefore, we will not draw any conclusions yet. Another small note, in this test Oppo strongly lightens black bars in this video. This is due to the fact that this file has incomplete resolution, 3840x2014, hence the conclusion, any video 7 and 8 profile, but with cropped margins, will lead to the inability to view this video on Oppo clone. Also slightly overestimates the black level on the black bars Fire TV 4K stick, probably due to non-prescribed parameters L5 and cropped fields. He made calculations for these non-existent fields as for the main image. As a result, slightly raised the black level, just on the black bars. At the same time, Fire TV Max does not have such a problem, but it is noticeable a slight decrease in brightness, according to the graphs even. But the output of the Oppo clone, we see instead of black, gray bars. You can also clearly see from the graph that the Shield TV overestimates the red channel level, its well-known red push bug. And the lack of response on the Oppo clone, look. Here without L1 prescribed. And here L1 optimal and L1 higher contrast, see no response, while Shield TV and other players give a reaction to changes in these parameters. The next test file, RPU P8.1 L1881 nits, is to test the response to different L1 levels. Here are the file specifications, 8 profile. CM2.9 L2 trim is prescribed for 100, 600 and 1000 nits. Here is a graph of how this L1 parameter changes in the original RPU. Here is what this file looks like in HDR. The peak brightness is 865 nits, and as you understand, this value does not change, since this is static HDR. On the first slide where max PQ equals 100 nits, I'll just read out the results. Dune, Fire TV 4K, Homatics Box, Zidoo, gave a peak of 783 nits, but Fire TV Max limited to 763 nits. Shield TV gave out 749 nits. But Oppo limited the peak brightness to 685 nits. Further, the situation does not change for max PQ equals 162, 200 and 325 nits. The brightness values remain as they were. Then max PQ equals 512 nits. If HDR is static and does not change here, then Dolby Vision is already trying to do optimization for the capabilities of your TV. Here Dune, Fire TV 4K and Homatics Box gave an identical brightness of 678 nits. Shield TV showed 672 nits, and Zidig gave a slightly different result. It did the same peak brightness, compressed the lower part of the range, raised the overall brightness of the whole image, except the peak, but slightly. Fire TV Max did something different. On the contrary, it lowered the whole image a little, except for the peak became level with the rest, but the overall brightness of the other elements of the image decreased. The Oppo did not react at all and did not change the image, it is equal to what it was at previous levels. In fact, the values of the other players just came back to what Oppo was originally at 100 nits. 512 nits is the value that this TV can output based on its characteristics. Recall that it has 807 nits prescribed. And then it becomes more complicated. Then max PQ equals 1000 nit. Here Dune, Fire TV 4K, Homatics Box and Shield TV produced identical 561 nits. Oppo is 10 nits higher, and Zidoo again slightly raised the overall brightness range. And Fire TV Max reduced the brightness to 508 nits. As you understand, the darkest image will be Fire TV Max, the brightest will be Oppo, the others are just a little darker than it. Then max PQ equals 1312 nits. This is where the entire picture is compressed across the range. The overall brightness increases slightly and plus a reduction of the peak to 488 nits for all, but Fire TV Max. Fire TV Max lowers the peak brightness to 322 nits, already a very significant difference between him and other players. It turns out that all players sacrifice the peak and average the overall image brightness, but Fire TV Max tries to keep the difference between the peak and the rest of the image. Then max PQ equals 2000 nits. Here the principle is the same, the peak is reduced to 443 nits and the range is also compressed. Again, only Fire TV Max has decreased the peak brightness even more. Now it is only 208 nits at the peak, the average brightness has also dropped a lot. Then max PQ equals 4000 nits. The situation has changed, there is no overall brightness compression here, and the whole picture has reduced the brightness of all to 346 nits at peak. Except Fire TV Max, it has managed to drop the peak brightness to only 140 nits. And the last value, max PQ equals 10,000 no reaction from any player. The brightness remained the same as for PQ equals 4000. Let us summarize for this file. Actually, this file is an imitation when the total movie brightness is prescribed, for example, for 4000 or 1000 nits. But the real fragment with 881 nits peak is displayed and players decrease the total brightness and peaks in order to leave a reserve when, for example, a brighter peak appears in the next frame, so the spectator can understand that there will be a brighter peak than in the current scene. As you understand, Fire TV Max was the worst performer in this test. It lowered the brightness too much, apparently trying to preserve the peak brightness in case a fragment with peaks under max PQ appears in the frame. That's probably the end of this first part. Thank you all, goodbye, the next part will hopefully come out soon.